What's good, everybody? It's your boy, O'Shane Duke Jackson, back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. Guys, I have been tagged in the Kevin Samuels Facebook group to a particular photo that is looming around on the internet. And at first it was just on groups and stuff like that, but then Media Takeout posted this particular story today about Kevin Samuels' high school photo. And we're dealing with the photo here. You see, that's him as a young man. Now that curl, stop the show, that curl is working with a little something. I gotta give him props. Almost look as good as my curl, but it's mine is a little better, as you can see. But as you can see, it reads, dang music! Kevin Roshan Samuels, Fred, is a Pisces who describes himself as unique. Kevin enjoys dancing, clothes, and meeting people. He is a member of the band, student council, stage band, MHS dancers, pep club, and the Bronze Gents. Kevin plans to attend OU and major in biomed. Now, what people are trying to say is this picture is proof that Kevin Samuels is a homosexual.
Oh my God!
Which, I have another video in which I'm gonna respond to that, where a Christian Instagram page insinuates this. But I'm not gonna deal with the homosexual allegation, because what I know Kevin Samuels to be is who he says he is. He's unique. He is unorthodoxed. He is a complicated man. I will tell you that. It's no diss towards him. Kevin Samuels is a unique nigga, okay? The way he operates, you don't know what he's thinking. You don't know what he's trying to do. He will call me in the middle of the night for whatever reason. I don't hear from him for like 3 weeks, and he calls. He's hard to predict. Kevin Samuels has always been a very complicated person since I've known him. That's always been a complaint. He's a complicated, he's unorthodox. I accept the fact that's who he is. That doesn't make him gay. It makes him complicated as hell in many ways. Unorthodox. He happens to like certain things that stereotypically in the black community, a man would not want to do. A man is not supposed to be dancing. He's not supposed to like clothes, especially clothes that fit. Meeting people, that's a sin. He's in the band. He's in a dance group. He's in the student council. But outside of knowing Kevin Samuels' personality as always being the person, I would say for the average person that would know him to be somewhat hard to deal with, but he's a nice guy. Here's what this is showing me. Kevin Samuels always wanted to be somebody. You see, here this young man was growing up in a single parent home. And despite the disadvantages that he had in his life, there's evidence that this young man was an ambitious man. He's always wanted to be somebody. He's always wanted to work hard. And he wanted to make something out of himself. And this was evident 33 years ago when this photo was taken. But then you come for him. And see, there are many black men out there like Kevin Samuels. You don't like what they like. Some brothers are into skateboarding. Some brothers like Metallica. Some brothers like chess. Some brothers like what they like. He is wanting to be a biomed, wanted to be a doctor or engineer. I'm in medical school, getting ready to finish in 2 months. Stop the show. And don't be hating on me, because if you come for me, I want all of that smoke. Unlike Kevin Samuels, I will deal with you. This is what I need. I really, really want you to come for me.
Huh?
But what I see is a young black man that wanted to be somebody. And despite what you say about him, he don't give a damn about what you think. He don't respond to you. He is still doing what he want to do, and he's doing it his way. And I wish that other black men under the sound of my voice, you would understand that you can be a complicated, unorthodox person in your personality. You can like things that other folks can't understand. But Kevin Samuels' proof is only as long as you understand your goddamn self, that's all that matters. I, for the like of me, don't understand Kevin Samuels. People call me, stop the show, people call me all the time because they know me and Kevin Samuels have a working relationship. So they ask me, can I reach him? Will he call me? You know what I always tell them? I said, nigga, I have no idea when Kevin Samuels is gonna call me. I have an intro that we did for him. He haven't responded in 4 weeks. I don't take it personal. That's how he is. He likes things and he does things differently than many of us. But he's a unique and special man, which is why he got more subscribers than me, which is why he make more money than me, which is why he make more money than you. And I want all the black men in America to know, stop letting people shame you for who you want to be. People want to come for you, your sexual preference, or come for you and call you a lame, or call you a nerd, or you're a geek, or you're a dork, or all of these things. I you know what? Nobody give a damn. Because in the end of the day, it's going to be Kevin Samuels buying all y'all broke people. He's going to be owning your homes. You're going to be still working at Wendy's. You'll be working at Burger King. You'll be out there wearing Jesus sandals and socks. And this is a young black man at the time who I look at his photo and I say, this man was not only probably keeping a good GPA, look at all of the extracurricular things he was involved in. He was trying to be somebody. He knew what it took to be somebody. He was a hard worker. He always wanted to be relevant and have a plan for himself. How many of y'all did something like this in high school? Some of you can barely read.
Stupid.
Some of you barely can write. Breath stinking. I'm going to be honest with you. Some of you barely can talk. Some of y'all have been making $300 a week for 30 years. And then you don't put in no effort to be anything out of life. Then you want to come from a guy who I'm pretty sure this year already has made over $1 million because he's successful. And that is what it is with the black community. A lot of people don't like the way how people have made a way for themselves. Some of you don't like me, Stop the Show Demon. I don't really give a damn if you don't like me. I'm going to continue to get this money. I'm going to continue to shine on you. I'm going to continue to get all of this that I can get. Booty clapping sounds. And I'm going to get those too for you ladies out there, planetoshe@gmail.com. You know what's happening.
Oh my God.
And the man is successful, uber successful. He has changed the game. He's a maverick in the manosphere. And it's a shame to see you go for a man. Now he ain't selling no drugs, ain't killed nobody. This is a young man that was trying to be somebody in life. Then you wonder why a lot of our young men lose confidence. People tell them that they can't do anything because they're different, and that all, you know, if you do that, you like boys and all of these other things, and you go this way and you go that way. And I want to tell you young men out there, don't worry about what folks say about you. They're not going to pay your damn bills. They're not going to give you nothing. They can't do nothing for you. Long as you know what you're going to have to do in life, that's all that matters. I can give a damn about what nobody say about me. And I hope you don't give a damn about what nobody say about you. And I want to thank the brother Kevin Samuels for opening the door for me. Because now, because of his content, I can make a few some money every month. I got the Kevin Samuels tax payment plan every month now. I'm a up my money. I thank the brother for opening the door, not only for me, but for other black men. To be able to come in and respond to his content and make a way for ourselves and take care of our family. I thank the brother publicly. And I need some more you other black men out there to come out and manifest your talent. Stop worrying about what folks think about you. Well, guys, it's your boy O'Shea Duke Jackson back at it again with another episode of The Celebrity Junk. I really appreciate you for all that you do. Subscribe, hit the bell, check out the first comment pinned to the top. And as you know, the buffoonery remains at an all-time high. I'm out.